I'm going to talk about the social determinants of health. The Commission on Social Determinants of Health defined the social determinants of health as the conditions by which the people live, age, work, and thrive. But also the social determinants of health are the more structural, upstream forces that shape those living conditions. And these are referred to policies, politics, ideology, culture, and so on. So social determinants of health refer to that entirety, the living conditions and also the structural conditions. Now, the important thing when we talk about the social determinants of health in this time is that the Commission on Social Determinants of Health since 2005 crafted the social determinants of health around the issue of health equity, meaning in order to understand why social and health inequities are growing worldwide, not only in our developing countries, but also in the developed world, in order to explain these huge health gaps in terms of equity, the only way of understanding them is to understand the social determinants of health that really produce these huge health gaps. And this is something that is new, because social determinants of health is not new in public health. In fact, this was more than 100 years ago by Rudolf Virchow. The social determinants of health were really conceived at that time. But this time, the important addition, is the linkages between social determinants of health and health inequities. Therefore, we never talk about social determinants of health in general. We talk social determinants of health as they relate to health inequities. Now, another important thing is that social determinants of health allow us also to understand better health promotion and health prevention. Meaning, you know, before, many years before you can get ill for a condition, you know, your conditions of life, you know, determine if you are going to be ill or if you are going to be healthy. Therefore, if you want to promote health and if you want to prevent illness, therefore the social determinants of health are central. Therefore, one of the most important applications in public health of the determinants of health approach is reducing health inequities, but also promoting primary prevention, talking about health and not only about disease. Also, something very important is that the social determinants of health is perhaps the best way of responding to social justice and to the promotion of democracy, because inequities that are produced by the conditions of the marginalized people, you know, the only way of addressing them is through addressing determinants of health, and that implies profoundly social redistribution and social justice. And therefore, we believe that is the best contribution public health can have to social justice and also to the promotion of democracy, but also to the strengthening of the economy. Because only when we have citizens that are equitable, that are equal, that are healthy, only then we are going to have economies that can really produce and thrive. Something also important is that the social determinants of health is the best way of connecting health with development as a whole. And this is because social determinants of health allude to the social conditions that relate to health. Therefore, it's like a bridge between development, society, and health. That's why when we talk about the determinants of health, it's perhaps one of the best contributions to the current discussions on the Sustainable Development Goals in the post-2015 development agenda. Because by having and by addressing the determinants of health, by understanding the ways the society as a whole produces health or produces disease, then we are going to be able to craft goals that are equitable and sustainable, not only for health, but also for development as a whole. That's why when there has been discussions about the health goal, as you know, it hasn't been only referred to disease or health systems. It has been referred to well-being and health in a more positive manner. Not talking about only about diseases, but talking about health. And that shows the importance and the relevance of the determinants of health approach for health in general. In the same way, When we talk about universal health coverage, which, as you know, is one of the most important and priority public health goals now, we need to talk about determinants, because it's not enough to have ensured access to health services to reduce health inequities. It's a necessary condition to have universal health coverage, but it's not sufficient. Being necessary is not sufficient. Only if you combine addressing determinants of health and ensuring universal coverage, we are going to be able to reduce health inequities. And this has been proved in many countries, like the Nordic countries, for instance, that have got full access to health services, and still health inequities are growing. So the only way of addressing that is to address the determinants of health. Now, all of these were subject of discussions and agreements by the international community in the Conference of Rio on the social determinants of health, where five streams were actually agreed upon, which are the most important one for addressing the determinants of health. One is improving intersectoral action for health, and my colleague Nicole Valentine will be talking to you more on this. The second one is addressing determinants of health also in our health sector, meaning, you know, improving the access and the social access to health services, and at the same time improving our public health programs. The third one is promoting social participation and social redistribution. The fourth is to align the different international actors in order to be able to address the determinants of health in a comprehensive manner from a development and development cooperation perspective. And the last one, but not the least one, is the one of measuring, because only if we are able to measure, we are going to be able to know if the policies that we are developing to address the determinants, whether in the health or in other sectors, are really going to be able to reduce those inequities. Some examples of countries that have succeeded, we have many. Those that have managed to develop in an equitable way, and perhaps we can have the Nordic countries as some of the best examples where social inequalities are perhaps more reduced. We have strong emphasis on the determinants of health inside the health sector and outside the health sector. But also countries that are at this stage managing to develop and to reduce health inequities and social inequities and economic inequities, countries like Brazil, for instance, where the Gini coefficient is being improved, reduced, you can see that they are managing to reduce poverty and at the same time improving health and reducing health inequities. So there are plenty of examples on how addressing the determinants of health, whether they call determinants of health or not, are already available in the world. The big challenges, just to finish, the big challenges that we're facing are still challenges in terms of the political consensus to address the determinants of health, because the issue of determinants is highly political and it has to do with social redistribution, which not all the stakeholders agree upon. So one is political consensus. The second one, which is also very important, is to have institutional capacities to be able to develop public policies that can address the determinants of health, and to have institutions that are capable to do so demand a lot of factors, time, staff, resources, and therefore the institutional capacities are very important to be addressed. And there is where WHO is actually focusing more, because in political consensus, it depends on each country. But in terms of developing the capacities, WHO has been working especially in three streams for developing capacities. One in the area of health in all policies. The other one is in improving the social determinants of health focus of public health programs. The third one is developing indicators and monitoring mechanisms that can allow countries to measure. And the fourth one is in improving the integration between social and environmental determinants of health, which are very relevant for, again, reducing health inequities.